I think about you all the time. The kind of life you might be leading. I wonder what you're doing right now, for example. Sometimes I think about the day we'll meet and what that will be like. The moment we see each other for the very first time. I imagine it taking place here on the seawall. On a day like this. And then I imagine us walking to the lighthouse and just talking about your life and the things that have happened to you. I'd really like to build up memories like that. By the way, do you ever think about me?
Welcome, everybody. In a recent survey, 98% of vets questioned said they had been asked to euthanize healthy pets. And in nearly all those cases, bad behavior is the reason given. Question: how do we deal with such ethical dilemmas? And just to be clear, this isn't some theoretical question about a situation that you won't ever find yourself in. It's very real. And in your world,
is this?
Barry, do you want to say your last goodbye to Betty?
So we're going to administer the injection now. She won't be in any more pain. Okay. She'll experience a shortening of breath and perhaps a dryness of the mouth, but that's quite normal, Derry. Just a sign that the drug is beginning to take effect. Rose.
That's it, Derry. It's all over. You okay? That was hard. You'll have to toughen up.
I know.
When I volunteered in the summer, I did a border collie, a poodle, 3 or 4 cats, 2 rabbits, and a ferret.
Really?
Trust me. You'll get used to it.
I'll get that. Hello?
Is this Ellen Wise?
Yes.
Formerly Ellen Byrne?
Love, I just need a minute. Who is this?
My name is Rose.
Okay.
Does the name Julie mean anything to you?
Why?
It's the name on my birth certificate.
I know from my adoption files you requested no contact, and I really shouldn't be calling like this, but I don't know what else to do. Hello?
Hello, can you hear me? I like the name Julie. When I think about Julie, I picture her like me, but different. Different clothes, different accent, different hair. For some reason, I always imagine her with short hair. I don't know why. I can't help thinking that somehow, if you had managed to hold on to me, I'd be living a different life right now. I'd be this other person. Perhaps the person I was really meant to be. The real me.
Hey, Dad. Sorry, I should have called. It's just been really busy here. How's Lottie?
That's good. Yeah, I'm fine. We're doing a module on euthanasia. Yesterday we should put down a dog. Yeah. I think the next one is a horse. Yeah, it is. It's really tough. Yeah, I'm fine. Yeah, I'm sleeping fine. Actually, I meant to call you. I'm going to London on Thursday. No, it's just for the day. To a conference on epidemiology. Yeah, it should be interesting. I will. Okay. I love you too. I was calling to see about one of your properties. I was just wondering if I could arrange a viewing. Yeah, I'll hold, no problem. Yeah, the house on Windsor Avenue. My name is Rose O'Connell. Any time today would be ideal. Three 30 with Valerie. Hi, I'm here for the viewing. I called Valerie earlier.
Yeah, she's on the phone right now.
Oh, okay.
You could come in and wait if you like.
Yeah, sure. This is a really nice house. Is that you and your mom? You look like her.
Think so?
Yeah.
Everyone says I'm like my dad. They're separated.
My name's Rose, by the way.
Eva.
Eva. That's nice.
I have some revision to do, so...
Okay, yeah. Don't worry about me.
Okay.
Actually... Can I, ask you something? What age are you?
I'm 16.
I see. Thanks.
It's Valerie.
Hi.
And this is Ellen, the owner of the property.
Hi.
You've already met Ellen's daughter, Eva.
Yeah, I have.
Shall we make a start? That's okay with you, Ellen?
Yes, yep, that's fine.
Mm-hmm. I was about to suggest that we start upstairs. This was the original show house when they built the development. Ellen's made a few changes, but she's kept a lot of the features. The fireplace in the hallway, which I'm sure you noted, and the wallpaper. Are you really looking to buy the house?
Oh, I do ask.
Well, it's just you look a little young, and I really don't want to waste anyone's time here.
The thing is, you're right. I am looking on behalf of
what?
A client? So, how many square feet is the property?
3,000.
Can we see Eva's room now?
Valerie?
I was just about to point out the ample storage space.
Could I have a word?
Sure.
Outside, please. I don't want an argument.
Neither do I.
Good. That's good. You need to leave now.
What if I say no?
You just said you didn't want an argument.
Look, I don't want to cause any trouble. I just want to talk. That's all.
Mom?
My flight leaves at 9. Then I'll be gone.
To be on my own, get away from things, this is where I come. Do you like walking?
Not particularly.
Walking's good for you. It's good for stress. It calms you down. It's a theory, at least.
I should take it up, then.
Can I ask you something?
Okay.
Eva, did you say anything to her?
No.
Because she knows nothing about you. Nobody does.
Listen. It's a nightingale.
I was raped. So, that's it.
How did it happen? Or can you tell me?
I was in my early 30s. And things weren't so great for me. To take my mind off things, I volunteered for an archaeological dig. I thought it'd be interesting. And the site was out by the coast, and it backed onto this golf course. And, it was summer. And he was... Sorry. I'm sorry, I can't.
I need to know who he is. His name.
Why?
Because I think I have a right to know.
And if I tell you his name, what'll you do?
Nothing. I just want the name. That's all.
After all this time, I can't say the name.
Can you write it?
Okay. Jump in, don't be shy.
Can you write it? Hi. I'm calling about the book launch this evening.
interesting?
It's about a nun who has psychic powers.
Seriously?
It's not bad, actually. I called your dad. I told him you'd be over later.
How long will you be in Dublin?
Not long. It's a small part. Sweet pea, that girl Rose, who came to view the house.
Yeah.
That's not her real name. Before. She used to be called Julie.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm looking for Peter Doyle. Could you tell me where he is?
Yeah, Peter. See those two guys over there? He's the one in the dark jacket.
Yeah, I see him. Thank you. Excuse me. Excuse me. I was wondering if I could volunteer for the dig.
Okay, have you got any experience?
No. It's just, I got this part in a play. My character is an archaeologist.
So you're an actress?
Yeah. So, I was hoping, if it's okay, that is, if I could spend some time on the dig.
Sort of like, for the play, kind of background research.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I mean, can you come back tomorrow?
Sure.
Sorry, I should have asked your name. I'm Peter.
Julie.
What's the play called?
It's called The Archaeologist.
You're the archaeologist?
Yes.
Push her around to the front. Come on, come on. You can stay in the corner there. Everybody happy? We've rechecked the weight of the horse. We're good with our calculations as to the volume of pentobarbital?
Yes.
Okay. Now, don't forget, only when the horse is properly secured for euthanasia can we begin the procedure.
I think if it were me, I would have had an abortion.
I thought about it. And came close. And sitting alone in the waiting room, that's when I decided to have you. So that instead of thinking about him and what he did, I could think about you. Out there somewhere. And the life you might be leading. I thought if I could do that, then maybe I might salvage something good.
Hi, it's me. I'm here in Dublin, working on something, costume drama. If you're free, I thought maybe we could meet up. I'd like that.
That's really good work. You're a quick learner.
Thank you.
That's okay. Could you want me to stay a little longer, or think you got the hang of it?
I'm fine, thanks.
That's great. Okay, I'll leave you to it then.
What's he like?
Who?
Doyle.
Oh, Peter.
You've worked with him before, right?
Yeah, he's nice. Why do you ask?
No reason. Just curious.
Hey.
Hey.
I'm Sadie.
Did anyone notice I was missing today?
Yeah, I did. It's okay. I covered for you again. What's this?
That's just for a party.
What party?
not a specific party, just if one were to come up, I thought I'd wear a wig.
So, like, a wig party?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Not sure it's really you.
There was a lady here looking for you.
Who?
She didn't say.
Where is she?
She's in your room.
Really?
Your friend, Molly? Yeah, she let me in. She seems nice.
She is.
I played a vet once.
Yeah, I know.
How'd I do?
You did okay.
That bad, huh? It's the hotel where I'm staying.
I know it.
Odd to be back after all these years. I never thought I would come back.
Why did you?
I came back because of you. Is that you?
Yeah. That photo was actually taken the day my parents told me I was adopted. We went for a walk to the lighthouse afterwards. My mom, she wanted to take a picture of me. She asked me to turn around, but I wouldn't. I don't know why. But I couldn't. She passed away 2 years ago.
What was her name?
Patsy.
Patsy.
I think you two would have gotten on really well.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Have you seen him?
No. Yes, I have. From a distance a couple of times.
I see. But you haven't spoken to him or?
No. Not yet.
Not yet.
Doesn't it bother you? He's out there, acting as if nothing happened.
See?
That's how it looked to me. And I am struggling. Really struggling with how that makes me feel.
So, kiss?
Mm-hmm.
Passionately, greedily.
The Baron.
What about him?
Consider, madam, the difficulty.
I have considered it.
And your child, too.
Yes, and the child, too.
And you would risk what? You would risk what? Just give us that line, will you?
Yes, and the child, too.
And you would risk all of this for me.
I would.
Come on down, take a look.
Sure.
What do you think that is?
Looks like an animal bone. A dog or a small boar, maybe.
You know, I was thinking I'm gonna have to take this sample in for testing, and I thought only if you wanted to, maybe we could meet up and talk in greater detail about the work that we do. Give you more insight. Just thought that might be useful. What do you think?
Yeah, I think I'd like that.
Good. Beautiful, eh? You wouldn't believe the damage they can do to our work.
So you've never been here before?
Actually, yeah, once before, on a school trip years ago.
What did you make of the exhibits?
Pretty interesting, don't you think?
Yeah, I do.
I mean, they're there, they're just right there, in front of us. Yet they possess all of this history.
You know, I think that's what I'm most drawn to in my work. Unlocking the past.
Why?
I don't know exactly. Oh, before I forget. Now, this photo is a publisher's idea, so it's a little embarrassing. There you go.
No. I think you look really good.
Really?
Do you think you look good?
Is that a trick question?
Yeah, it is.
Just in case you ever need to call me. I mean, you never know, just put it on your phone. Can I say something?
Sure.
Your hair?
What about it? I
really like it. The color, the style, it just suits your... It suits your face, the shape of your face.
Why are we here?
Excuse me?
Why did you ask me to come here?
I just wanted you to know how pleased I am that you volunteered to work on the dig. mean, I know you just, you know, this research for this acting thing, but you've got this natural ability. You're really good.
Really? That's all?
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
What weight are you?
I'm going up now.
Good night.
Julie.
Hi. I was in the area and I thought I'd stop by, say hello.
How did you know where I lived?
I called your office and here I am.
Come on in. Just go straight through there.
Your wife?
Yeah, it's Teresa.
Your sons?
Yeah, well, no, they're Teresa's sons, Thomas and Sean, but they do see me as their father. Yeah. We met when they were young. Do you have any brothers and sisters?
I do, yeah. I have a younger sister, Eva.
That's nice.
It is. You have a lovely home.
Thank you. Except it's really Teresa's home.
Oh?
Yeah, our parents built it for her and her first husband when they got married.
What?
What?
I don't know. All of this just makes me think how lucky you are.
Yeah, I never really thought about that before.
Really?
No.
Would you mind telling me where your bathroom is?
Yeah, sure. It's upstairs on the left. I'm in here. You were right.
About what?
About me being lucky to have this home to live in. You know, Teresa, the boys, my work. I do think about it, you know? I don't take it for granted. Do you know what Do you know what the really great thing is about my work? The surprises it brings.
Like what?
Like, a rare artifact, for example. Or someone like you. Am I embarrassing you?
No.
It's funny you being here, don't you think?
Funny how?
Well, people might be forgiven for thinking that there's something going on.
But nothing is going on.
Really?
No.
An attractive young woman, alone with a man, in his house, in the middle of the day, when his wife is out. See what I'm getting at?
Yeah, I do.
Can you recall when we first met?
Yeah.
Can you recall an attraction? I can. Why doesn't that wife come around to my house? To see me?
No.
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 I think that really, deep down, you want this.
Stop.
In fact, I think you've wanted this since we first met.
No, just stop. Listen, I want you to stop.
You know what? I don't think I will stop.
Does he know who you are?
No.
Well, who does he think you are?
He thinks I'm someone called Julie. And that Julie is his daughter. You know, I would have done it. If the syringe hadn't broken, I would have put him down. I wanted to.
Okay.
Did you tell Eva about me?
Yes. I told her she has a sister.
And that's all?
That's all.
I'm not sure that I want her to know everything, not what I am. I don't want her to have to stop herself when she remembers who she's talking to.
How is the gym? Can we sit down?
I don't want to sit down. What I want, Peter, is for you to explain this. And whatever happened in there, that, Peter, is what I want.
Okay. Is this girl a young woman?
What young woman?
Julie.
Julie. Do I know her?
No.
Well?
Apparently she thinks I'm her father.
And are you?
No.
So she's lying then?
Yes, or she's confused, or she's mistaken.
Or maybe, just maybe, you really are her father.
Not feeling too good.
You know what? I am gonna sit down.
What age is she?
What difference does it make?
Just tell me her age!
I don't know. 22, 23, maybe.
Okay, well, at least that's something.
Jesus Christ, how many times do I have to say I have never cheated on you? Never.
What about her mother? How is she?
I'm not sure.
Peter!
I'm really not sure.
Look. Look. Look at you. What the fuck is going on?
Yeah, but, I mean, how long is that gonna take? Out here? I mean, just look at it. Don't you think it would be cruel to just leave it here like that? Such pain. You might want to look away for this. It's not gonna be nice. Look away!
Thank you.
Rose. We need to get rid of all of these. Is this pay as you go?
Yeah.
Is there anything else?
There's some syringes back in my room, too.
Where in your room?
In a... It's a box file in my study desk.
Anything else?
No.
You sure?
Actually, there's two bottles. You have to be really careful with them.
Okay. You were my first pregnancy. And I had always wanted a child more than anything. And yet, when you were born, I never actually looked at you. Not really. Wasn't able to. I felt empty inside, like I didn't know who I was. And there you were. And I never actually held you. Can I hold you now? I thought I could never love you. And that you were his child. I felt like I could never be your mother.
You are my mother.
I am.
Hello? Yes? Who? Yes? Yes? Okay. Yes?
Do you know why I said we should meet here?
I can imagine.
Really?
Yeah. I haven't forgotten.
Okay, that's good. But the details. Do you remember them? I'll refresh your memory.
There's no need.
I insist. Everyone is packing up to leave when you asked me to stay back. I recall feeling flattered, so I said I would. You said you'd something to show me, so I followed you away from the site and onto the golf course. We went over by a bunker. It's very isolated. And you began with small talk. The view, the weather, usual. And then you changed. I could see it. And I told you I was uncomfortable. I looked around and I could see how alone we were. I got frightened. Maybe you sensed that. I liked it even. And then it started. I told you to stop. I said no. I said no. And then you punched me. Hard in the chest. And I was winded. I was terrified. Do you remember? I need you to respond.
Yes.
Yes, what?
I remember you said no.
But you didn't stop. Did you?
No.
When it was over, we both walked back. I stood under that tree, do you remember?
Yes, I remember.
I didn't know what to do, where to look. I felt ashamed somehow, like I smelled bad. Whereas you seemed relaxed. Like nothing had happened. This woman asked if I was okay. And she brushed some grass and mud from my clothes. I don't know. I was lost. And I didn't tell her what happened. I said nothing. Julie. Julie is Rose. My daughter.
If I hadn't known...
She was your daughter, you wouldn't have tried to rape her. I was someone's daughter.
I know. Inside... me, it's not very nice.
No. No, I don't imagine it is.
Okay, stop, stop. Please. Just stop, please. It's okay, just let go. I'll keep my hands away. I'm not gonna touch it. I just need a moment.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. I was just dreaming about us. I dreamt I was on the seawall. The sun was breaking through the clouds. And I'm waiting for you.